हेलो फ्रेंड्स,
माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर दीपक कुमार द्विवेदी।
टुडे
आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस
डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम ऑफ पाइला ग्लोबोसा,
दैट इज एपिथेलियल स्नेल। इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन।
द डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम ऑफ पाइला
कंसिस्ट ऑफ three part: a tubular alimentary canal,
paired salivary gland, and a large digestive gland. So first of all, we will study alimentary canal of pila, which is divided into three parts: foregut, midgut, and hindgut. Foregut is also known as stomodium, and midgut is also known as mesodium, and hindgut is also known as proctodium. Foregut is ectodermal in origin, midgut is endodermal in origin, and hindgut ectodermal in origin. Now first foregut, it includes following parts such as mouth, which is a vertical slit present at the end of the snout. There are no lips, but bordered by small fleshy edges which serve as secondary lips. Now buccal mass, mouth opens into a buccal mass containing buccal cavity or pharynx. The skin around mouth becomes thick and folded and forms mouth sphincter is present. This is the vertical longitudinal section of buccal mass. Here you can see various structures are there, and the vestibule, this is vestibule, which is the anterior part of the buccal cavity. Inside the buccal mass, this complete buccal mass, and this is the vestibule. And behind this vestibule, there are two jaws. This is jaw. There are two jaws. Jaws, that is, they are paired, hanging from the roof of the buccal mass, and those are provided with muscles, and their anterior edges possess teeth-like projections. Is denticles for cutting up vegetable food, and buccal muscles, these are median dorsals, one anterior dorsolateral, three pairs, posterior dorsolateral, two pairs, anterior muscles, three, lateroventral, one pair. So these are the buccal muscles, which are 16 in number. Now we will discuss odontophore. This is the structure present inside the buccal mass. This is odontophore. This you can see here. It is a laterally compressed platform of muscles arising from the floor of the buccal cavity. It arises from the floor of the buccal cavity, supported by two sets of cartilages. First, these are paired triangular superior cartilage present at the top of the odontophore. And second, these are also paired, which are S-shaped, and lateral cartilages. So odontophore, actually it forms a subradular organ on anterior side, which forms a roof over a narrow space, that is sublingual cavity. So here you can see this is the subradular organ, which helps in cutting of the food. And odontophore is provided with well-developed muscles. Muscles surround the odontophore, which support it. Now next is radula. Radula, you can see in the previous diagram that this is the position of radula, which is present inside the radular sac. So Here you can see this is the radula, is the characteristic of phylum Mollusca, and you can see that there is a bag like structure, radular sac above and behind odontophore, and it is a diverticulum of the buccal cavity. Odontophore is a diverticulum of the buccal cavity, and this radular sac contain rows of teeth, and actually it contain also cells, and these cells are known as odontoblast. There is a tough elastic subradular membrane which covers the odontophore and lying under the radula. So radula is present inside the radular sac, and the radula is made up of many transverse rows of horny teeth, and each row has 7 teeth. You can see here 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. These are the 7 teeth, 2 marginal, 1 inner and 1 outer, right? 1 lateral tooth on each side. This is lateral tooth on each side, and a central or rachidian tooth in the middle, which gives a formula 2 1 1 1 2. So it gives a formula 2 1 1 1 2, that is outer marginal, inner marginal, lateral and median rachidian. So this is a single row of radular teeth. This is the structure of jaw where cutting edges are present. The radula, actually it is a rasping organ secreted by radular sac in which odontoblast cells are present. And you can see that radula moves forward and backward on the odontophore for rasping the food particle. And the central rachidian tooth, this is roughly rectangular, and lateral tooth are rhomboidal in shape. So each tooth bear 2 or more cutting projections. Here you can see here, these are the cutting projections or cups. Radula is secreted by the radular sac. In this, the odontoblast cells are found. They secrete teeth and subradular membrane. Old parts of radula are replaced by new ones. So there, and another structure inside the buccal mass is a pair of grooved buccal glands on the roof of the buccal cavity above the radula, and these are digestive in nature. So this is all about the radula, which is the characteristic of phylum Mollusca. Now, the third part of foregut, the esophagus. The buccal mass leads into a long esophagus. This is the esophagus, long and narrow part. And you can see that a pair of esophageal pouches here, partially covered with the salivary glands, which finally open into the lumen of alimentary canal. And these pouches store food temporarily, and digestion begins in them. So this is the esophagus provided with esophageal pouches covered with salivary gland. Here you can see in the diagram clear. Now the second part of the alimentary canal is midgut, and is divided into 2 main parts. These 2 main parts are stomach, number 1, and number 2, intestine. Stomach, here this is the stomach part. And here you can see that esophagus opens inside the stomach, and which is a large U-shaped tube of dark red color, embedded partially in the hepatopancreas. And the stomach is divided into 2 parts: cardiac chamber, which have longitudinally folded interior, and pyloric chamber, second part, interior lining with transverse folds. And pyloric part, it gives rise a blind diverticulum called cecum. And the hepatopancreas is bilobed. From each lobe arises duct, and 2 ducts join before opening into the cardiac part of the stomach. They open, both glands, opening of both gland occurs in the cardiac part of the stomach. The stomach part. Now, second part of the midgut, this is intestine. And intestine actually runs backwards and arising from pyloric end of the stomach. This is the intestine, and it turns upwards and backwards in the visceral mass, where it forms 2.5 or 3 coils between the gonad in front and digestive gland below before joining the cecum. So next part is hindgut number 3, the third part of the alimentary canal, and it has a single terminal part that is a rectum, which is a thick wall tube. It enters the mental cavity and opens by anus shortly behind right nuchal lobe. Now next, salivary glands. These are paired glands, occurs on each side of buccal mass posteriorly and partially covers the esophagus, and its secretion contain mucus and enzyme amylase, which digest starch. Now digestive glands, these are also known as liver or hepatopancreas, and it is a somewhat triangular plate like structure. Two ducts arise from two main lobes of digestive gland, and they unite and open into stomach. The gland is made up of many fine tubules known as alveolus, and rest of the tubule is ciliated. So the alveoli has three types of cells. Number one, secretory. Number two, reabsorptive, and number third is calcareous or lime cells. So these are the three types of cells occur inside the alveoli and the digestive gland. Now come to the feeding and digestion. Actually, the food of the pili is soft, juicy leaves of aquatic plants, and it is caught by the jaws of pila. The radula and jaws are operated by muscles, which causes forward and backward movement. And this chainsaw mechanism changes the food into small particles. And the secretion of salivary glands actually mixes with food in buccal cavity, and it digests starch. The digestive glands pour their secretion into the stomach. And the secretion of digestive gland digests various types of food, but cellulose is digested inside the resorptive cells only. Therefore, in pila, both extracellular and intracellular digestion occur, and stomach is the site of extracellular digestion, and digestive gland is the site of intracellular digestion. The absorption of the food mainly occurs in the digestive glands, and some part of the absorption occurs in the intestine. So this is all about the digestive system of pila. And subscribe my channel to get all my videos, and thank you very much.